So now we're dropping their interest rate down into the, you know, mid to low threes. And so the savings between just the difference in interest rate and removing that mortgage insurance is going to save them a lot of money. So if you are out there, you haven't done a refinance yet, now is a great time. Interest rates are still great. And we've got some big news to talk and share about that too, because Movement Mortgage made some huge moves this week. And obviously, Mortgage Mom Radio is my radio show, but we work for Movement Mortgage, and we put our loans through Movement Mortgage, and they are just absolutely fantastic, especially right now in this, you know, time, you know, where there's a lot of companies that are slowing things down. So, Heidi, you want to give some good news?
Sure.
All right.
I love giving good news.
I know. I'll let you give a couple of the announcements out. So what do you got?
Okay. So I missed the announcement yesterday and I was really bummed, but I got to watch it today.
Okay.
We have some changes. So we went over last week, right? We were on last week. Last week, some of the changes that were not necessarily for the better for our clients, but it was based on investor decisions and who would and who would not take certain types of risks. So Movement Mortgage really stands behind their motto, right? They are all about challenges and change and really rolling with it and trying to make the best of it. So they stepped up today and made, or yesterday, and made some amazing decisions to support our clients, our family. So I'm going to just go over some of the conventional changes, if that's okay.
Yeah, sure.
And I'm going to let Debbie say why we can do so.
Okay.
Because I think it's huge. Okay.
Yeah.
So for conventional programs, we went over some really big changes that maybe would have made some of our current borrowers, clients no longer be eligible to do programs right now.
Right.
Refis their transactions, right? Whatever that may be. So we have now gotten some of the restrictions reduced from what they had made them. So we are now back to, if we have an investment property, we do have to have the 720 FICO score, whereas we were kind of limited on whether or not we could do some investment properties.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
We do have home style programs that we can now do again.
Okay, so let's just explain what home style is really quick, because a lot of people, they don't know. This is our mortgage lingo, right? So a home style loan would be a renovation loan that you're going to do through Fannie Mae. A renovation loan through FHA would be an FHA 203K, but it is a renovation loan. So for a minute there, we didn't even have it. They had taken it away, and now it is back. We do have it. So now the credit score is 720 to do that home style loan. FHA, we can still do that renovation loan as well. And off the top of my head, I do not know what that FICO score needs to be right off the top of my head. I know a lot of new changes. 680? Okay, thank you. There were a lot of other changes that bring that down where we were struggling last week. We had to have, you know, a minimum of a 640 credit score, or a 680 credit score. We couldn't do cash out. There was a bunch of changes. So I'll let you keep going. What else is new?
Okay. So then manufactured housing.
Yes.
I promise.
That's okay.
We are at back down to a 640. We went up to a 680 last week.
That's
so we can do them again. We can do them at a 640, which is big.
Yes.
It's back, which is amazing.
Yes.
I do have all of the requirements right here. So I'll let you kind of go into why we can do those. And then if you want me to go through the other specifics, I can do that.
So, well, with a manufactured home, the one thing I do want everybody to understand is that there is a big difference between a mobile home and a manufactured home. So if you are thinking about buying a home that is a manufactured home, make sure that you call us. At the end of the day, they're all built the same. They all look the same, but they are not the same. So it's truly the difference between whether or not the unit has gone through all of the requirements necessary to change it from personal property to residential or real estate. So you do want to make sure that you're reaching out to us if you're thinking manufactured, but having that credit score dropped from the 680 back down to the 640 is really a fantastic change. All right, so what's next? We've got, go ahead.
We have our government program.
Yes.
Okay, so FHA, VA, USDA, which we don't do a ton of because out here we don't have a ton of rural property. It's a really hard word for me. I don't know why.
Rural.
I, you know,
depends on how you like to say it. Rural. Okay, yeah. Go ahead.
So we have a lot of really positive changes that really help the clients that are in those markets.
Hey, how would you like this? My dad, for the longest time, forever, they didn't have addresses. So they were rural route 4. And the postman had to know which house belonged to Aaron Bosich to deliver the mail.
Right.
Because they were all route 4. There was no number, no anything. Anyway, so just as you were mentioning the name, the word, it just brought me back to childhood. But anyway, all right, keep going.
That's so funny. Okay, so minimum FICO score, unless there's other restrictions, okay? So, but for the most part, minimum FICO score is back down to a 620, okay? We could go below that before, but we are back down to a 620 where we were depending either a 640 or a 680 last week.
Right.
So we're now at a 620.
Yeah. So to just to make sure that you, to everybody listening, cash out is different than a rate and term or a purchase. So a rate and term and a purchase, we can now go down to 620 with an FHA loan, where we used to be able to go down as low as 580, sometimes even lower. We got bumped up to 640. If it was not cash out is 680. Cash out is still 680. They have not taken that away. But we have dropped in the rate and term and the purchase arena from 640 back down to 620. So that is, again, it's a giant win. That difference between 620 and 640, although it's only 20 points, it truly does exclude a lot of people from the market of being able to refinance their home or be able to purchase.
Absolutely. Also, manufactured home stays at the 640 for FHA as well. Cash out, like you said, is 680. So it is staying there. Investment property is still a 720.
Okay.
And we say that because most of the time you can't do government.
Investment,
but there are situations that you can. So VA cash out cannot be greater than 90%.
So no more 100% cash out.
Yep. And then the rates, because of what Movement is doing, has allowed us to have a much better rate opportunity with these loans.
Yes. So let me explain what the big announcement was on top of all of these changes to the loan programs, which is fantastic. We are just absolutely so thrilled. I really do believe that we work at the best place that we can, especially for the industry. They support us as loan officers. They support you as our customers, our clients, our family. You know, they're making sure that we're bringing those loan programs to you. You know, as of 3 weeks ago, there was really no jumbo at all in the market. We couldn't get our hands on a jumbo loan. We now have, I counted it today, we have 5 jumbo investors that are back on the books that we can do. We don't have a cash out for a jumbo loan right now, but we can definitely still do a refinance, drop your interest rate, get you into a purchase. So they're finding us those programs that we need. And they took it one step further, and they are now with all of our Fannie, Freddie, all of our conventional and government loans, we are now servicing our own loans. So we are no longer going to be selling the note after you close to a different company that will then take your monthly payments for your servicing. We are going to actually hold those loans. The reason that they're doing that is that, again, we talked about this last week in our show, the reason that we had to change all of these credit scores to be so much higher is that there isn't an appetite in the market right now for those lower credit score loans. And we did not want to start turning people away. So they put their big boy pants on and they said, okay, we're going to hold them, we're going to service them, and we're going to offer these products where other banks aren't. So just giant. Now, what comes along with that, Heidi? What is the benefit of that to us as well?
So the benefit to us is we have your loan. We can work with you. We are servicing your loan. It's not going to someone else. You can reach out to us when you have, you know, concerns. You want to talk to us. It's not, you did your loan with us, you made your first payment, and now it's off to GovernMill.
Right.
It's a popular one. So, again, nothing wrong with GovernMill. They're a great servicer. We get a lot of compliments on them. but it's no longer here with Movement Mortgage.
Right.
So yeah, when you get your information sent out, you're going to get Debbie's information on it.
Right, right. But there's a bigger win to that even.
Rates. Rates.
Yes. So because we're cutting out the middleman and we're keeping it in-house, we now have better margin for sales. So our rates are also much, much better. Anybody that talked to me last week that called me this week or put in an application with me on Monday heard from me on Tuesday or Wednesday or Thursday or Friday. And, you know, your interest rate got better from what I had quoted to you. So obviously the market is moving up, it's moving down, it's moving up, it's moving down. If we locked your rate in 2, 3, 4 weeks ago, you're probably, if not almost closed, already closed. Rates were totally different at that rate lock period. But if you started a loan with us last week, late last week, Friday, started the loan with us this week, and you've heard from me about locking in the rate, I guarantee I offered you a lower rate than what we started with. So, you know, that was one of the benefits of them rolling them out as well, is that we've been able to also step up and give some better rates out. So, you know, where I was going with the savings that we found for that one client is that there are still a lot of people out there that have loans with interest rates that are too high. There's still a lot of people that are out there with loans that have mortgage insurance, and rates are still very, very good. We've been quoting rates in the mid to low threes, depending on the program. Are there still interest rates being quoted near four? Absolutely. Are you an investor and you've got an investment property and we're going to refinance an investment? Is your rate going to be around four, maybe a little bit higher? Yes. Do you have a lower credit score? Yes. You know, your rate might be a little bit closer to four. Are you trying to pull out cash? You're going to probably be in the mid to high, you know, high threes. So depending on your loan program, that rate can change. But for that perfect borrower, perfect credit score, a ton of equity in your home, and all you're trying to do is drop your interest rate and lower your monthly payment, and your loan amount's under $510, $400, you include all of your taxes and insurance in your monthly payment. Do you see where I'm going with this, Heidi? They need to understand everything that goes into this rate, right? They're in the
And we talk about it all the time, right?
We do. I locked one in today at 3.187 on a 30-year fix. That is phenomenal. That was at 0 points. Does everybody get that interest rate? No. But what rate can you get? We need to talk to you. We need to know what you've got going on. We need to know, what do you owe on your house? How much equity do you have? Are you trying to pull out cash? Where's your credit score? Do you include those taxes and insurance? You know, where do you live? What kind of property is it? Is it a single family, a condo, 2 to 4 unit? All of those things are going to change what that interest rate is that you will get. But if you want to know if you should, you need to call us and get on the calendar, because I am the first person, and I say it about 5 times a day, 5 brand new calls a day. You're in good shape. Don't do anything. You're in good shape. Don't do anything. I say it every day, all the time. And when it does make sense, I'm going to tell you that it makes sense.